Hello, hello the students. Today we will discuss the metamorphosis in Lepidoptera. You know, Lepidoptera insects, they are most familiar and easily recognizable of all insects. And it is in this order that coloration has reached the highest degree of specialization. Do you know who are the Lepidopteran insects? Butterflies and moths. These insects have always been popular objects for study, and more than 1 lakh species have been described till date. Now, we have to know what is metamorphosis. During the period of post-embryonic growth, that means after hatching, an insect undergoes a series of ecdysis or casts of its integument. By this process, it attains its maximum size. The stages between ecdysis are called stadia, and the form attained by an insect in any stadium between two ecdysis is termed as instar. That means, when it emerges from an egg, it is in its first instar. Then we call that first instar larva. At the end of this stadium, it undergoes an ecdysis and assumes the second instar, and so on. The first instar, second instar, thus it goes to the final instar, and final instar is the adult or imago. The changes an insect undergoes to become an imago are collectively called metamorphosis. Do you understand? The total changes. You have gone through the metamorphosis of some insects. There are 4 stages: egg, larva, pupa, and the adult. But in insects, there are 2 types of developmental stages. One is nymph. What is nymph? The young which hatches from an egg is a miniature of the adult. When that is the miniature of the adult, then it is called a nymph. It differs from the adult in having immature reproductive organs and so on. By several molting and growth, it becomes an adult. The metamorphosis of a nymph is of 3 types. It may be ametabolic, heterometabolic, or hemimetabolic. Depending upon the grade of changes occurs during the transformation. But in Lepidopteran insect, the metamorphosis is holometabolic, because here the young stage which hatches from the egg is called a larva. What is larva? The nymph is also free swimming, and the larva also free living. But the larva is very different from the adult in structure, body form, mouth parts, legs, and in its mode of life also. The larva has lateral ocelli in place of compound eyes. It feeds voraciously grows, moves about, and undergoes ecdysis. Can you follow me? The larva is so different from the adult that it first changes into a resting, quiescent instar called a pupa, which is often enclosed in a cocoon secreted by the labial glands of the larva. Now, first we have to learn the formation of or the structure of an lepidopteran insect and its four stages. Okay? First, we have to learn the external anatomy of an adult. That means the imago of a lepidopteran insect. The body is divisible into head, thorax, and abdomen. In head, the greater part of the head is formed by the frontoclypeus and large globular compound eyes. The ocelli are two in number and lie close behind the eyes. They are seldom conspicuous and generally much concealed by scales or often apparently absent, though they may be concealed within the head. Okay, now the antennae. The antennae are composed of an indefinite number of segments and are very greatly in length and structure. In the male, they frequently show an increased development as compared with the female. Practically, they are generally scaled dorsally and very often frontally, ventrally also. In some cases, scales are absent. When we come to mouth parts, in the majority of Lepidoptera, mandibles are totally wanting and the maxillae are highly modified to form a suctorial proboscis. You know, for taking honey, they need a suctorial proboscis. When not in use, the proboscis is spirally coiled and stored away beneath the thorax. It presents an extraordinary variation in length. Okay, this is all about their mouth parts. Now come to the thorax. The thorax is made up of three portions: prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax. The prothorax is evident in the lower forms, but compressed and reduced in all the higher families. The mesothorax is the largest and most prominent segment of the three. The metathorax is relatively small as compared with the previous segment. Thorax bears legs and wings, you know. With regard to the legs, a meron is present in relation with the meso and metathoracic cocci. And as a rule, the cocci have but little mobility upon the pleuron. The principal movement of the base of the leg being in the articulation between the coxa and trochanter. The insect, this insect, Lepidoptera insect, has two pairs of membranous wings, cross veins, few in number. The body, wings and appendages clothed with broad scales. Mandibles almost always vestigial or absent, you know, and at the bases of the wings there are acrotorial organs and in some cases a well-developed tympanal organ is associated with them. What is the tympanal organ? This tympanal organ or tympanum have evolved in Lepidoptera to allow them to detect the echolocation calls of predatory bats. Now we have come to the abdomen. Abdomen consists of 10 segments. The first segment is reduced and its sternum wanting or wholly membranous. The 7th and 8th are sometimes slightly modified in relation to the genitalia, and the 9th and 10th segments are greatly modified in the latter respect. This is all about the imago or the adult insect. Now, come to the egg stage. The eggs of Lepidoptera are roughly divisible into two forms, ovoid or flattened. With the long axis horizontal in this type, the cell is usually only ornamented with rough pitings and rarely with longitudinal ribs. Second, upright and either fusiform, spherical or hemispherical, with the axis either equal or the vertical axis the longest. The ornamentation is usually more complex and often exhibits a cell-like structure divided by longitudinal ribs. The micropyle is usually placed in a slight depression at one extremity of the horizontal axis of an ovoid type of egg and at the summit in the upright form. Practically, the duration of egg stage is subject to great variation. It may be as short as 2 days, but for species which hatch out during the year of deposition, 10 to 30 days may be taken as the usual developmental period. Now, from the egg hatch out the larva. Lepidoptera larvae have a well-developed head, 3 thoracic and 10 evident abdominal segments. 9 pairs of spiracles bound respectively on the prothoracic and first 8 abdominal segments are present. In the head, the median epicranial sulcus is well developed and the fronds is usually represented by a pair of narrow oblique plates termed the adfrontals. The thorax carries a pair of legs on each segment. These are 5 segmented, and the terminal segment or tarsus is provided with a single carved claw. The abdomen commonly bears 5 pairs of so-called prolegs, which are present on segments 3 to 6 and on 10. The first four pairs may be termed the abdominal feet and remaining pair the claspers. The larva have short three-segmented antennae and mind that the mandibles are very powerful and adapted for mastication. After the last instar larva, the larva changes to the pupal stage and usually first becomes evident by cessation of feeding. In many cases, the larva desert the food plant and wander in search of a suitable site in which to undergo the transformation. Larva has also head, thorax and abdomen. In the head, the vertex forms the dorsal area of the head behind the epicranial suture, while the region anterior to the latter is the frontoclypeus. In the thorax, the three segments are distinct on the dorsum, but ventrally they are concealed by the appendages. The anterior pair of wings almost entirely conceals the posterior pair, except for a narrow strip along the dorsal margin of the latter. In the abdomen, 10 abdominal segments are present and a certain number are always fixed and immovable. The greatest number of free segments is found in the more generalized forms. Spiracles are present on the first 8 segments. The first pair is usually covered by the wings and the last pair is vestigial. Now we have gone through all the four stages. From the pupa it comes out the imago or the adult. Practically, in this stage, appendages are formed, muscles, trachea, and parts of the alimentary canals are replaced by corresponding organs of the imago. Such vast changes are called holometabolic metamorphosis. In these insects, there is an internal reconstruction during late larval and pupal instars. Practically, larval organs, with the exception of central nervous system and developing reproductive organs, are disrupted. Their breaking down is called histolysis. This is brought about by phagocytes which feed on the organs, and products of their digestion are then used for building new structures. The building of new structures is brought about by growth centers called imaginal buds or discs. Imaginal discs are groups of formative cells which are set aside in the larva. They are the rudiments of future organs of the imago. They form legs, mouth parts, internal organs and wings. This process of formation of organs of an imago from imaginal discs inside the pupa is known as histogenesis. and it results in the formation of the imago. Thus, two embryonic, practically post-embryonic processes occur in all insects. The first is growth in the young, and the second is metamorphosis, in both of which molting takes place. Both processes are controlled by hormones of endocrine glands. Insects have two such endocrine glands. They are corpora alata and prothoracic glands. The juvenile hormone of corpora alata controls growth and molting up to the end of the larval period. So long as the juvenile hormone of corpora alata is produced, the final molting into a pupa or into an adult cannot take place. The prothoracic glands are a pair of small glands in the first thoracic segment. They produce a hormone called ecdysone, which brings about molting and development of imaginal discs and reproductive organs. When both hormones are secreted, then molting of larva only will take place. The result of the two hormones is suppression of adult characters from appearing during larval and pupal instars. When only ecdysone is secreted and the juvenile hormone is not produced, then the larva will molt into a pupa and the pupa into an imago. Thus, it's seen that ecdysone is essential for each molting, but its action is modified as long as the juvenile hormone is present. Removal of the old cuticle is ecdysis, is brought about by an enzyme secreted by the hypodermis. The enzyme erodes the lower surface of the cuticle. Then the hypodermis secretes a new cuticle below the old one. And this is all about the metamorphosis, the process of metamorphosis, what is metamorphosis, and all the description of all four stages of Lepidopteran insects. Remember, I have given only the skeletal structure of the metamorphosis note. First, hear it, listen it, then you will make your note according to your choice. Okay? Thank you.